And we have indeed made the Quran easy to understand and remember. Then is there any that will receive admonition?
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم كلاس السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته
الحمد لله Last time, if you recollect, I have introduced to you a pattern root, فعلا, and we have started calling it Mr. Fa'ala. So our radical fa is presented with a specific color, that is blue. Radical ayn is in red color, and radical lam in green color. We have also noted last time that when the subject fa'il is 3M1, that is third person masculine singular, then the verb ends in a, as alima, jahila, sadqa, qara'a, kataba, dakhala, kharaja. When the subject fa'il is 3M1, verb ends with a. So now let me use this signs to you, and if you could give me the root, it will be highly appreciated. Class, ready?
Alima.
Alima.
Jahila.
Jahila. Jahila.
Sadaqa.
Sadaqa.
Qara'a.
Kataba.
Kataba.
Dakhala.
Kharaja.
Yes? Should we make progress? Yes, fine. Alhamdulillah. Please read. Da'ufa. 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 The root meaning for da'ufa is to become weak. So, what will be the literal meaning in perfect?
He became weak.
He became weak. That is, 3M1 became weak. Third person, masculine singular, is the subject of da'ufa, fa'il of da'ufa. And here, the verb ends with a. The verb ends with a. Da'ufa. Da'ufa. And this will be our sign. Da'ufa. Da'ufa. So, class, ready?
Jahila.
Jahila. Jahila.
Alima.
Alima.
Sadaqa.
Sadaqa.
Da'ufa.
Alhamdulillah. Progress? Yes, inshallah. Now, let us take another route, and that is, please read.
Jalasa.
Means to sit. So, what will be the literal meaning?
He sat.
He sat. And this will be our sign. So, class, ready?
Yes.
Da'ufa.
Jalasa.
Alima.
Alima.
Jahila.
Qara'a.
Kataba.
Dakhala.
Dakhala.
Kharaja. Alhamdulillah. What do you say? Progress? Inshallah. Good. Yes. Another root. What is the subject of this? Akala. What is subject? 3M1. Third person, masculine singular. The verb ends with a. The verb ends with a. Now, akala, the root meaning of akala, to eat. So, what will be the literal meaning?
He ate.
And this will be our sign. This will be our sign. So, class, ready? Yes, fine.
Da'ufa.
Da'ufa.
Akala. جلس
خرج
دخل
صدق
علم جهل
كتب
قرأ
Progress? Can I take another one? Would you please read one of them?
Sami'a.
Sami'a. Sami'a. The root meaning is to listen. So what will be the literal meaning?
He listened.
He listened. He heard. He listened. He listened. And this will be our sign. So now, class ready?
Yes.
Yes.
Akala.
معروفا
جلس
سمع
كتب
قرأ
جهل
علم
صدق
خرج
دخل
الحمد لله very good progress and the final one
Akala.
Should we take more?
Kadaba.
The root meaning of kadaba, to lie. So what will be the literal meaning?
He lied.
Since we do not like lie, so we'll just cross it. This will be our sign. Kadaba. And we just endorse what? Sadaqa with yes sign. Kadaba with cross sign. This we don't want. Kadaba. So, class, ready?
Yes.
Sadaqa.
Kadaba.
Akala.
Sami'a.
Qara'a.
Kataba.
Dakhala.
Kharaja.
Jalasa.
Alima.
Good. And
Jalasa.
Dawfa.
Sami'a.
Please read.
Dhahaba.
For Dhahaba, we can invent this sign. That is 11 number bus. 1, 1. 11 number. Pollution free. Dhahaba. Pollution free. Dhahaba. Fine. So, should we start?
Yes.
Good. Alhamdulillah.
Alima.
Jalasa.
Jahila.
Sadaqa.
Qara'a.
Kataba.
Dakhala.
Kharaja.
Dawfa.
Jalasa.
Akala.
Sami'a.
Kadaba.
Dhahaba.
Let me write one more here. Please read.
Shariba.
And this will be our sign. All right. Class ready. Yes.
Akala.
Shariba.
Dakhala.
Kharaja.
Jalasa.
Sami'a.
Qara'a.
Kataba.
Sadaqa.
Kadaba.
Alima.
Alhamdulillah. So, when the fa'il, subject of a verb, when the subject of a verb is 3M1, third person, masculine, singular, the verb ends in what?
Fatha.
A sound. A. And here please note that last time we did learn that as far as radical ayn is concerned, radical ayn in different roots either accept fatha. Can you spot? Where the radical ayn, please, radical ayn except fatha?
Fatha.
Sorry?
Sadaqa.
Qara'a.
Kataba.
Kataba.
دخل خرج جلس أكل كذب ذهب.
And would you please spot when the radical عين except كسرة
علم
علم
جهل
جهل
سمع
سمع
سمع سمع and where the radical عين except ضم
ضعف
ضعف ضعف ضعف as compared to this فتحة and كسرة ضم roots are few. But alhamdulillah, we have noted that it is possible for radical ayn to accept either fatha, kasra, or dhamma when the subject is 3F1, that is third person feminine singular, then the verb ends with at. When the subject is 3F1, the verb ends with at. When the subject is 3M1, the verb ends with what?
At.
When the subject is 3F1, the verb ends with what?
At.
Now from my signs, if you could give me 3F1. Class. Ready?
Yes.
Sharibat.
Sharibat.
أكلت ذهبت
ذهبت 11 number bus pollution free ذهبت ذهبت
جلست
جلست
أكلت
جهلت
صدقت
كذبت
كذبت
قرأت
كتبت
دخلت
خرجت
ضعفت
سمعت
الحمد لله. We have done that whenever the subject is 3F1, that is here, when the subject is 3F1, the verb ends with what? At. Now what I suggest is, why not we just use these both, whichever sign I demonstrate. First of all, look my sign, and whatever I demonstrate, then you please give me the verb. All right? Fine. Class, ready? Yes? So let me take in my hand and then show you this. This will be better. So careful, class, all right? And that will be puzzle.
Akala.
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 Jalasat.
Jalasat.
Qara'at.
Qara'at. Qara'at.
Kataba.
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 I didn't give you the sign. All right, fine. Please wait for my sign. I appreciate it, admire your enthusiasm. All right, fine. Yes?
Dhahabat.
Dhahabat. Dhahabat.
Akalat.
Akalat. Akalat.
Shariba.
Shariba. Shariba.
Da'ufat.
Da'ufat. Da'ufat.
Alima.
Alima. Alima.
Jahilat.
Jahilat.
Dakhalat.
Dakhalat.
Kharajat.
Kharajat. Dakhalat. خرجت
جلس
جلس جلس
جلس
جلست
كذب
كذب
جلس
جلست
كذب
كذبت كذبت
صدق
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 دخلت
دخلت
خرجت
ما شاء الله
جاهلة
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 جاهلة الحمد لله. Class has made very good progress. Now as usual we can go to our write-up inshallah and try to see that what we actually learned. The verbs, perfect verbs in Arabic are normally triliteral, consisting three radical letters. But there are a few quadriliteral verbs. They include two tenses, the perfect and the imperfect. The English past tense and the present perfect tense correspond to the Arabic perfect. Arabic grammarians use the verb fa'ala, he did, the third person singular masculine as a root and also as an example pattern. This pattern is frequently used in this work. It is therefore necessary to understand it. The radical letter in fa'ala is fa, the medial is an, and the third radical letter is lam. The medial radical ayn in a triliteral perfect verb may carry fatha, kasra, or dhamma. But the radical fa and lam carry fatha in all roots. The following three verbs give examples of these possibilities for the radical ayn. Fa'ala, kataba. The radical ka stands for fa, the radical ta stands for the medial radical ayn, and ba stands for the third radical lam. Kataba, he wrote, is the third person singular masculine 3M1. 2. Fa'ila, jahila. The radical ja stands for fa, the radical he stands for ayn, which carries kasra, and lam stands for the third radical lam. Jahila, he remained ignorant, is 3M1. 3. Fa'ula, da'ufa. The radical dad stands for fa, the radical ru stands for ayn, which carries dhamma, and fa stands for the third radical lam, da'ufa, he became weak, is 3M1. Just as with the English language, Arabic verbs are either transitive, requiring a direct object to complete the sense, or intransitive, which do not take a direct object. And a few others are both transitive or intransitive, depending on their use. The pattern fa'ala generally retains the transitive character, as in kataba, he wrote, or akala, he ate. But there are a few roots which, although they share the same pattern, that is fa'ala, retains their intransitive character, such as jalasa, he sat. The pattern fa'ila generally gives intransitive significance, indicating a transient state, section, or quality, either in a person or in a thing, as in alima, he knew, jahila, he remained ignorant. The pattern fa'ula is intransitive in its character and indicates a permanent state or inherent quality, as in da'ufa, he became weak. Certain verbs, depending on their use, are either transitive or intransitive, as in sami'a, he heard. Rule number 18. If the subject is third person singular masculine, 3M1, the verb ends with a. Example analysis: Musa alima, Musa knew. In the above example, Musa is third person masculine, 3M1. And he is also a subject. Therefore, alima ends with a. Rule number 19. If the subject is third person singular feminine, 3F1, the verb ends with at. Example analysis. Maryamu alimat. Maryam knew. Maryam is third person singular feminine, 3F1, and she is a subject of the verb alimat, which ends with at. What I suggest now, that alhamdulillah we have noted this, let us go to our text and who can volunteer? Number one to be recited, please. Number one.
Man alima.
Man alima. Who knew?
Huwa alima.
Huwa alima. He knew.
Al abu alima.
Al abu alima. The father knew.
Al rajulu alima.
Al rajulu alima. The man knew.
Al waladu alima.
Al waladu alima. The boy knew.
Musa alima.
Musa alima. Musa knew. Please note, in this, huwa is a subject. Man, first of all, man is interrogative particle. Alima is triliteral root. The root meaning is to know, and the literal meaning, he knew. So man alima, who knew. Huwa is 3M1, personal pronoun, is subject, so he knew. Al-ab here is subject, or rajul here is subject, followed by the verb. Al-walad is subject, followed by the verb. And Musa is a subject, followed by the verb alima. Who can read number two? Naam.
Man alimat.
Man alimat. Who knew?
Hiya alimat.
Hiya alimat. She knew.
Al-ummu alimat.
Al-ummu alimat. The mother knew.
Al-mar'atu alimat.
Al-mar'atu alimat. The woman knew.
Al-bintu alimat.
Al-bintu alimat. The girl knew.
Maryamu alimat.
Maryamu alimat. Maryam knew. Would you please point out from number two, which are the subject? Which are the subjects, please?
Hiya.
Al-um.
Al-um.
Al-mar'a.
Al-bintu.
Al-bint.
Maryam.
And Maryam. These are the subjects. And what is the character of this subject? What is the gender of this subject? Yes, they are feminine. 3F1. Third person feminine singular. So here, the verb ends with what? At. At. All through. At. Who can volunteer the third, please? Yes?
Man jahila.
Man jahila. Who remained ignorant?
Huwa jahila.
Huwa jahila. He remained ignorant.
Jahila al-ab.
Jahila al-ab. The father remained ignorant.
Jahila al-rajul.
Jahila al-rajul. The man remained ignorant.
Jahila al-walad.
Jahila al-walad. The boy remained ignorant. Now here we have brought deliberately the verb first. In the previous two, we brought the subject first, and it is possible. When subject is brought first, the sentence is known as nominal sentence, and when the verbs are brought first, the sentence is known as verbal sentence. So here now, when the subject is 3M1, the verb ends with a. When the subject is 3F1, the verb ends with at. Alhamdulillah, we are making very good progress, and inshallah, we'll try to learn more in our next lesson. Thank you. Barakallahu li wa lakum والجميع المسلمين إنه تعالى جواد كريم ملك بر رؤوف رحيم.